Static meant to the industry, he was the go-to guy. He, his harmonies and melodies were so unique that everyone in the industry, you know, wanted to get a Static song. His music always was before its time. So, you know, he could write a song and 3 years later, the same song could be a hit. So he just had an ear for the future. He got great because of his work ethics. He worked continually. You know, he lived in the studio. If he could drink or eat music, he would be, I always told him he would be fat. You know, because that's what he did. He thought music was like breathing. I think it just is a natural gift from God. You know, it was easy to him. You know, God gave him that gift, and there would be times where he couldn't even sleep at night from dreaming about music. And he would wake up and record on his little microphone. When he and Timbaland and Missy, Ginuwine and Devontae, when they first started out, they all lived in the same house. This is what was told to me. Like I said, I met him after the Player album. So, and they all just recorded. You know, they stayed in the studio. They learned from each other, and actually they competed with each other. You know, they made each other better. Like I said, there would be times where we would hear music on the radio, and Steven would say, "I bet Missy wrote that." Just because he knew her style, you know. And, you know, so that's because they work together so closely. She's right, baby. Well, in my opinion, I think that the music is kind of lost right now. It's like, I don't know. I think the music industry really, really misses Steven. Anywhere I go, they ask, you know, he was just so talented, he was just so gifted. And where he was then, I just can't imagine where he would be today, because he continued to grow. He competed with himself. He wanted to outdo anything that he'd done before. And his music touched all kind of artists, from Destiny Child to Jay-Z to Nas, Pretty Ricky, so many that it's hard for me to, Jamie Foxx, I lose track, you know, because there's so many people that Steven worked with. He had a lot of respect in the industry. Like, he was a star to them. You know, they're the star to us. He was the star to them.
Music is it's like breathing. Simple shit.
It was every day they kept on wanting to hear our shit, dog. He said, "I got tired of hearing y'all shit." He said, "I didn't even realize y'all shit roll like that." He said, "Until I heard all the songs back to back," he said, "I was like, oh shit." He said, I didn't really know that they was dope like that. So he said, it surprised me too. He said, "Them niggas feeling y'all, man." He said, "Y'all niggas are out of here." So he said, "Shug said he gonna make sure ain't nothing wrong with y'all niggas' son." He gonna push the shit out of y'all. Ah!
Steven, he was such a competitive person. I mean, even he grew up playing sports. He played football, so he had this competitive spirit, and he would always say, "R. Kelly, I'm coming for you." So R. Kelly was the one he was trying to, you know, come for. He just knew, like, I remember the day he came home with the Lollipop song, and he was like, "Baby, this is a hit. This is a hit. I promise you it's a hit." And I was like, "Let me hear it." And I listened to it, and I was like, "Yeah, that sounds good." And at that point, it was just another rapper on it. It wasn't even Lil Wayne on it. And finally, he started talking. He was like, "I think Lil Wayne would be good for this." So somehow or another, he ran into Lil Wayne, and he told Lil Wayne, "You never had a number one hit." And Lil Wayne looked at him, and he was like, "Excuse me?" He was like, "You never had a number one hit." He said, "But brother, I'm about to give you your first number one hit." So he handed him a Lollipop. So, 2 weeks later, I remember me and Steven was at dinner. He got a phone call, and he said, Lil Wayne recorded Lollipop, and it's gonna be his first single. He was like, "Baby, I told you. I told you it's gonna be a hit." So he's like, "Okay, email it to me." He couldn't wait to get out of dinner. So we can listen to the Lil Wayne version of Lollipop. And we listened to it. He was so extremely excited. He knew that this would open the door for his project because he was almost finished with his own album. So he was like, "I'm about to take over. This is it. I'm about to take over the industry. I'm gonna run this." His album was gonna be called Supper Time. And people were asking, "Why was he gonna call it Supper Time?" And I asked, "Baby, what's up with this Supper Time?" And he said, "Well, I'm calling my album Supper Time because it's time to eat." So basically, I'm giving this album to the world. Because I'm gonna eat. Okay, the lollipop video. Steven was so excited about the Lollipop video. He kept calling me, "Baby, we're doing this, we're doing that. Guess who just came in? Baby just came in." He was just so excited. And then he called me one time. He was like, "Baby, I think I'm gonna go to the Grammys with Lil Wayne and Baby now." And I was like, "Okay." And I said, "When is it?" He said, "It's next week." And I said, "Okay, well, that should be fun." Okay, so he ended up not going. He came home and he was like, "Baby, I decided not to go." And I said, "Why?" He said, "Because I'm gonna wait to go to the Grammys when I get my own Grammy. Next year when I get my own Grammy." And I said, "Well, okay, what you gonna say?" He said, first of all, I'm gonna thank God. I'm gonna thank you. I'm gonna thank my mama for instilling the music in me, for dragging me to the choir rehearsals. I'm gonna thank my babies, Makari, Donnie, and Steven. I'm gonna thank my sister for beating me up every day. I'm gonna thank everybody. I'm gonna thank Jomo and Barry, and I'm gonna thank everybody. He said, "But I'm getting my own Grammy next year." And he did.
So I decided to do a talent search because Steven left behind so much music, and I've been kind of contemplating on what to do with this music. So through prayer, I decided to do this talent search.
OG Music and Makari Music Inc. present Static Major Search for the Next Big Star. If you think you've got what it takes to become Louisville's newest star, then this call is for you. Stop what you're doing and get online and register now at staticmajor502.com and at b96jams.com. This call is going out to hip-hop and R&B artists and producers ages 9 through 30. This talent search is going down Saturday, September 11th from noon until 5 at Club Envy, 570 South 4th Street between Chestnut and Muhammad Ali. If you've got what it takes, this is the one talent search you do not want to miss. How often do you get a chance to perform already written music by one of Louisville's legends, Steven Static Major Garrett? OG Music and Makari Music Inc. giving you that chance, so don't miss it. Register now at staticmajor502.com and at b96jams.com for a chance of a lifetime. Static Major Search for the Next Big Star, Saturday, September 11th, noon to 5 at Club Envy, 570 South 4th Street. Be there.